What's up, boys and girls? All you children, gather around because I am coming to you all today with some knowledge. I did a little research, my clipboard. I'm gonna be sharing with you all today hair porosity. Specifically, what kind of hair porosity do you have? Is it low porosity? Is it high porosity? Are you somewhere in the middle? What kind of products do I put in my hair? What kind of treatments should I do? Should I use heat? Let's find out today. So if you have medium hair porosity, that's actually considered very healthy. So we're not gonna talk much about that today. We're gonna talk more about low porosity and high porosity. So low porosity hair have extremely closed cuticles. So that means that it's hard for moisture to get in. So you really have to find ways in which to open your cuticles, get moisture in, and then seal them back. High porosity hair, your cuticles are gaping open like this, and moisture can easily get in, but it easily also comes out. So in and out, very easy. Can't really hold it, so you need to get products that will really help you with that. There are different tests to see what kind of porosity your hair has. However, some of them really aren't reliable, like the water in the glass. You can't really tell if your hair is low or high porosity because the temperature of the water could have something to do with why it's floating or sinking. Everyone's hair has natural oils. You can't really tell if it's your hair that's floating or the oil that's on your hair coating it is making it float. So the best way to see if you have low or high porosity is to actually get one strand of your hair and actually rub upward on the strand. So if it's smooth, then you have low porosity hair. If you feel bumpy going up the strand, then that means you have high porosity hair. That is the best way of knowing how porous your hair actually is. From there, you can really know how to deep condition your hair, whether or not you need a lot of protein treatments or not, what kind of products you need, whether it's thicker or more lighter creams and moisturizers and things of that nature. So it's very important to kind of go there as your baseline. So for low porosity, you're probably going to notice that your hair has, you know, product buildup. It sits on top of your hair. It takes forever to treat your hair as well. And your water sits on your hair. Like, it takes forever for it to really get wet. And it also takes forever for it to dry as well. Thick products make your hair greasy. Kind of just sits on your hair. Your hair is also protein sensitive, so you really shouldn't be doing a whole lot of protein treatments if you have low porosity hair. Once every month or two, you should really do a protein treatment. Don't really do more than that. One great thing for you to do is when you're doing your deep conditioner, you need to use heat to open up your cuticles on your hair shaft. So a lot of people, including myself, don't have hooded dryers at home, but there's one great product that I really want to show you guys. I bought off Amazon. My girlfriend Haley told me to get it. She was like, this is gonna change your hair forever. Let me go grab that actually. One second. It's called Glow by Day Los Angeles. I'll link it below so you can check it out. It comes in this little pouch and you connect it to your hair dryer. I'm telling you, this is like great. This is a life hack. If you got curly hair or you want to do a deep conditioner and you need to apply some heat, girl, you literally like do it like this. You literally put it on and it like blows up. Attach this part to your blow dryer. You would actually put it on medium or low heat. When you put it up too high, it's like baking your scalp. But this is great to do for like 20 minutes when you're doing a deep conditioner. Highly recommend. If you don't want to buy something, what you can do is just wash your hair in the shower with hot water so your cuticles are open. You can also heat up your conditioning agent, whatever you're using. Also, if you want to, I do this when I have nowhere to go and I'm kind of just around the house. I get like a grocery bag and put it over my hair and just tie it, and I just chill around the house for an hour and it works perfectly. The heat of your scalp and your head and your hair will actually keep the cuticles open if you bag it. The best products to use would be on the lighter side, kind of runny, very light. And then the right oils for you to use would actually be argan, grapeseed, jojoba oil. Those are the top ones you should really be using. So for high porosity hair, if you felt the bumps going up your cuticle shaft, then this one is for you. Typically, it's either you have damaged hair or highly processed hair. You might find some issues with your hair, such as it can't hold a style, it gets tangled easily. All of your cuticles that are open are getting stuck into each other, and so your hair is easily getting tangled. You might notice that it dries quickly, you're seeing a lot of frizz, you have dryness, lack of shine, you're seeing all these different things. Your hair will love proteins. You want to do a protein treatment maybe twice a month, maybe more than that if you see that it needs more. If it's not holding curl, it's lacking shine, it's not holding your style, and it's frizzing up and it's just dry all the time, you need to do deep conditioner and protein treatments. Typically, I would like to do a protein treatment first and then add the moisture afterward. That's kind of my process with that. A couple of tips I would like to give you is cold water will help seal your hair. So rinsing your hair with cold water will really help. Also, apple cider vinegar is your best friend. So apple cider vinegar will actually flatten your cuticles. I would actually add in apple cider vinegar into your deep conditioner. Just a few drops, don't do anything crazy. So it's like this, it's gonna help it kind of go back down. Now, when you have your cuticles open like that, you have high porosity hair, you need to use heavier creams, butters, oils, products that will help fill in those gaps, fill in your cuticle, and help also seal it off. You're gonna wanna use some oils that are more heavy, so coconut oil, olive oil, avocado oil, things like that. Jojoba oil is nice too, but that's more on the lighter side. Also, you can use aloe vera and apple cider vinegar together. The aloe vera will actually help you balance your pH out, which is gonna be very helpful, especially since you're putting something acidic into your hair. So definitely mix those two together and put that in your conditioner. You can also put it in a spray bottle. Another way of seeing whether or not your hair is high porosity or low porosity is if you take a spray bottle and spray your hair. And if you see beads of water on your curls or on your hair, that means you have low porosity hair. However, if you spray your hair and it quickly absorbs into your hair, then you know it's really looking for that moisture, it's dry, and it's going straight into your cuticles and in your hair shaft, that's high porosity hair. So you definitely want to aim, if you have damaged hair and you have high porosity hair, you want to aim towards having medium porosity hair. So making sure you do all your treatments correctly, keep up a routine for your treatments, because I know it's super easy to kind of just wash your hair, use a regular conditioner, get out of the shower, but if you really take care of your hair, it'll come back to life. So some of my favorite protein treatments I like to do is, first of all, Olaplex is amazing. I'll link it below. Sephora sells it, a lot of stores sell it. So Olaplex is a bond builder, and they are scientifically patented. Isthebomb.com. I highly suggest them. It's a bond builder. They are top notch in the market. Highly recommend. I use them once or twice a month for my protein treatments. I highlighted my hair, so I made it a little bit more porous than it was originally. I have medium porosity hair, and whenever you do highlights, it makes your hair more porous and your cuticles go up a little bit. So you need to really give your hair more attention and care if you're really doing some things to your hair. I'm trying to see, is there anything else I want to add today while I have my thinking cap on? I think the main takeaway is if you have low porosity hair, you need to make sure you use heat when you're deep conditioning to get the cuticles to come up. So when it goes back down after your deep conditioner, all that moisture is sucked up and sealed and you're good, you're great to go. If you have high porosity hair, after doing everything you did to your hair, all your conditioning, your treatments, you need to rinse your hair with cold water in order to seal that. And you need to use oils like coconut oil, olive oil, avocado oil. Just kind of experiment what really works for your hair. That will help fill your cuticles and seal it. All right, everyone, I know this was a little bit more informative video that I put out today, but I had a few requests to do porosity, and helpful to know, even if your hair isn't super curly, it's wavy, or you don't really know where it is, this is a great place to start to learn about your hair and how to take care of it properly. All right, everyone, so until next time, let me know what else you would like to see, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye.